Evening, folks, this is Best in Slot welcoming you back to Caldera National Safari Park. In today's video, we are going to try to... Oh, they're fighting for Alpha Stays. We are going to try to Gold Star the park, which means we need to bring in cheetahs. And it means we need to bring in lions. So we're going to work on the cheetahs first. Let's go see if we can find any in the market to kick things off. Is it just called cheetah? It is indeed. Now, I have to add two of them. And they're hella expensive, so this is confusing for me. So I need to grab her. And then we need to... I guess we need to be releasing animals into the wild and get CC, which is like the first time we've had to do that. The difference in price is quite low, but the fertility is actually the same. So we're gonna grab Budua and Aquila. There we go. Lovely stuff. The idea is to turn this little area here into the cheetah enclosure. I just need to decide if that makes any sense whatsoever. And I believe it does, so let's give it a go. Now, I did try this already, and it went disastrously badly. Like, super, super badly. So I'm going to give it another go. And what I'm going to do is not attach to this fence here, because I think that's what's causing me the problems. I'm just going to attach onto there, and then I'm going to go curvy. Get rid of angle snap. And we're just going to make a little exhibit. Like so. Okay, that's not going to work. Need to come at it from the right angle. There we go. Now we move on. Well, they get the little sticky outfit, and the lions get the little sticky outfit. Everyone deserves a little sticky outfit. Okay, this is my worry again. It's always the bloody... I don't bloody know. Like, why is that highlighted right now? I don't know. Like, surely that's not part of this. I don't know what's going on, I'm just going to ignore it, and we're going to attach onto there instead. And the hope is that this will work. There we go. No, it again hasn't worked, look. Oh, I don't understand. Urgh. This is the exact same form I had last time. It just doesn't form an exhibit. This should, right here, be an exhibit. It really should, there's no reason it shouldn't be. But it's not. There's no gap anywhere. Like, I bet if I put... I'm going to put in a thing. I'm going to put in a habitat gate. Somewhere. I'm going to put a habitat gate there. And it'll shout at me in a minute. I'm like 90% sure it's going to shout at me in a second. But we'll see. We'll give it a chance to prove me wrong. Get rid of some of our... Oh, you... Okay. Oh, God. Oh, so many matured. And offspring. Babies everywhere. Right, let's... Everyone who's matured... gets released into the wild. You're doing that. What are you doing? You're also heading off to the wild. Who is dirty? You are dirty. Call keeper. I don't see why, though. Is it the water? The water's fine. It says green as though it's being treated. I think that must be a bug, because there is a water filter right there. So, why would it... not be treated. I'm gonna get another water filter. I believe I've been warned about this already. And that it doesn't work, essentially. Also, this appears to have worked. I'm gonna try to get the cheetahs delivered into here. I'm not totally convinced this is working. We'll have to wait and see. Let's give it a go. Animal trading. Storage. Move. Oh, it did work. Sweet. I think not attaching it to those fences has really helped. Let's get our cheetahs in. Very cool. What we should maybe do as well... let's put a little staff area here, because that's a hell of a track. Let's get rid of some trees. Alright, I apologise, folks. I've spent the last 10 minutes recording, and apparently I, mid-video, somehow hit my recording button. I don't know possibly how that was the case, but, well, we've had to skip forward a little bit, which is annoying. But I got my cheetahs, as you can see, this one. Here, looking at the camera, really awkwardly, actually. So, the cheetahs have been put in, this exhibit is fine, just add a little shelter, some food and stuff like that. Go. No idea what that was. Terrifying. But yeah, everything should be hunky-dory. Yeah, sorry about that. All that happened was put the cheetahs, that got us up to silver. Bernie popped up and said a really terrible pun about how cheetahs are hard to manage because cheetahs never prosper. Get it? Nudge. And then he mentioned going to get snow boots. I wanted to mention this in the last video. We didn't really talk about it. But there is very much the implication... from Bernie at least, right, he's going to go open a zoo in the Arctic. That's his whole goal, right? That's what he's doing right now. He mentioned it in the last video, and he mentioned it today as well, but unfortunately I lost that footage. No idea how. No idea. Does that imply we're getting an Arctic DLC next? That's definitely the opinion of a lot of people I know in the community. Arctic is an area that's been a little bit neglected. You know, we don't have penguins, we're not polar bears and stuff like that. It would make a lot of sense for our first expansion pack, our first DLC, to be Arctic focused. That would be really cool. So maybe that's what it's going to be. We're going to get like a little extra campaign mission where we have to go make an Arctic zoo. That would be awesome. Right. What are we doing with our lives? I'm going to build a lion exhibit. What's all this? Water treatment inaccessible. I know, that's fine. Everything else is failing, that's fine. They're fighting for alpha status, that's fine. So what have we got to do? Well, you can get updated. Already done the education and conservation. We need two new West African lions. So we're going to need quite a lot of CC. We actually probably can't afford the lions as is. We need to breed one more type of animal and then release 11 animals into the wild. Nothing that difficult except the guest numbers. If I'm worried about any of them, it is the guest numbers. Let's build ourselves. Well, first things first, can we get any lions? Let's see what we can do. I had to spend some CC just to get the, Yikes. Okay, so I assume then the plan is when our baby animals grow up, is we release them to the wild and we get enough CC to... It's cool that, because it kind of prepares you for what it's like running a franchise. You know, you have to breed your basic animals to be able to afford fancier animals. I like that idea. Maturity. Who are my newest adults, basically? A lot of them have been sick, and I really don't know why. I can release a couple of springboks, that's not a problem. A couple of African wild dogs, maybe. Just got to make sure we've got enough to keep the population going. I think what we'll do is we'll just wait for animals to hit maturity, generally speaking. Get rid of those. So, keep an eye on here. When an animal hits maturity, we just straight out send it to the wild. That's going to be a plan. And we're going to build a lion exhibit right here. I think this makes a lot of sense. It's attached to this bit over here. No, it's not. I can maybe attach it to here. This is my little staff area I did for the cheetahs. Which, again, you would have seen if the game randomly didn't stop. Oh, I really thought that was going to fit. Damn. Disappointed! Yes, beautiful. I don't know how this is working, but it is, and I'm here for it. Okay, because I want I want those staff members to be able to get over here. Okay, up again. No, is this a bad idea? It's probably a bad idea. The more I look at it, the more I think this is nonsense. This is utter nonsense. But doing it anyway. By what? Oh, there's a thing. No, there's... what? Okay. Call that round. Bring it down. There we go. There we go. Beautiful. Staff bath. It makes sense. Plus, it means the car gets to drive through a little bridge. And I love myself a little bridge. Yeah, there's a problem here with this habitat. The habitat can't be cleaned. Like, the water is permanently saying it's in need of cleaning. I actually have two water filters on this right now. And it's still green. I don't think there's anything we can do about it. As far as I can tell, my animals are just going to keep getting diseased, you know? Like, unless I'm missing a trick. I've heard people talk about it, like they can't clean this water and it's going to stay green. Springbok. They're not really worth much, are they? I really don't know what to do about it, if I'm totally honest with you. It's not necessarily a problem as long as I... keep my vet. No, I'm going to hire a couple more vets. I already think I've got tons of them already. I've got 12 vets, you know? We've got plenty of vets to manage the situation, but I'd rather they're not in need of managing. You know, I'd rather they're just happy, but I can't seem to... I don't know what to do about it, really. It's a shame. It's a pain in the ass. Who is boxed? I saw someone boxed. You are boxed. Why are you not moving? Get over there. It's all a disaster. I'm not even doing anything wrong. Why are you without power? I don't understand. Power source failing. Now the protests. Oh my god, it's all gone to hell in like no time at all. Like it genuinely has. I really should fix this up. You have power. There's a. No, that's not a power. I'm just going to stick another one in. Is that going to be. Yeah, that's fine. Until whatever's fixed is fixed, stick that there. That should give it power again, right? No, maybe not. Where's the actual building for this? It's there, goddammit. Alright, okay, we're going to need a slightly bigger. We need a little bit more power. There we go. Right. Get rid of our matured animals. That's going to get us a little bit of moolah. We need some bigger stuff though. We need the elephants and stuff like that, really. But hey, we got that done. We've released 11 habitat animals into the wild. And we're getting there. 747. We're not a million miles away. We're boying right now. Let's see if we can grab one of the lions. That would be cool. Oh, sweet. 320. Oh, I'm so close. I'm so close. I need four and we can get it. Yeah, screw it. Let's... We need one. Where are we getting points? Is it from... No, I have no idea. I have no idea. Come on, one more. One more. One more. One more. Don't tease me. Don't go four for... There we go. There we go. Sweet. Both lions that we needed. Good stuff. So, I'm just going to ignore all the terrible problems and we're going to go build a lion exhibit. That sounds like a good idea. barriers. So I'm just going to wrap some brick around this bend. Might make it one-way glass or something. We'll have to see. Let's just get the basic exhibit shape done to kick things off. What do I want to include? This area here, I think. Where's the cheetah? Cheetah's there. And then we can put something there if need be as well. Like I said, I'm not totally convinced by my animal numbers. So I'm a little worried about them. My guest numbers, I should say. So we might need to... Can I do this? Yeah. Like, do another exhibit and just bring in a few more animals and get things a little bit fancier. I think the main problem is going to be we need to bloody stop our diseased animal problem, but how? Like, I don't really have a solution to that right now, unfortunately. There we go. Lions. Lions. That's my ex of many years ago would say. Let's put that there. Let's get some staff path. Move me a bit of staff path. You know what I don't love is when I have the railing turned off. It looks silly. That's so much better already. Look at that. Beautiful. That's the staff path you would take home to meet your mum. Right, let's get those lions delivered and we'll go from there. Boop. I just have to have faith that eventually all my problems will go away. That's the best in slot method. Only four left. What am I meant to do about this? Seriously. It's all these habitats that have this water in the middle. There's no fix for it. I'll do my best, folks. I'll do my best. Anyways, yeah. So, we're far away from the guest numbers we need, but what we can do as well is maybe do a little bit of marketing. What we'll do is we'll wait till the lions come in and they're happy, and then we'll go ahead and do it. And hopefully that'll be enough to ram our numbers up just a little bit more. Where are my lions? In transit, how far are we? Oh, we're nearly there. They're on their way, boxed up and ready to go. Bright-eyed, bushy-tailed, and ready to spend. Oh, I did it! No, I didn't. What am I about? Of course I didn't do it. Like, I thought... Oh, never mind. I was optimistic. Why would I gain 600 guests out of nowhere? Okay. Good stuff, though. Lion time. Right, we need to flatten this area down, because they're definitely going to break out of there. There's our lions. That should be good for our guest numbers. We'll have to see if it's enough. Let's, first of all, let's make sure they're not going to break out. It seems to be top priority, really. Now, what the hell? Yeah, we're looking good. We're looking good. Right, obviously they're depressed, which is bad, so we'll have to fix that as well. I did have some research going on the cheetah, which makes me suspect the lion isn't going to have much either in terms of... Yeah, unfortunately not. What can we do? Environment's fine. We need some hard shelters, what we need, and then we'll have to mess around with the terrain a little bit. Put them in there. Bam, bam, bam. I love how that looks there. The heat map actually makes things look really cool in general. Get that in, get that in, get that in. Can a lion be contained in one way glass? Let's have a little look. Let's do some science. And by science, I mean clicking like two buttons. Grade 3 climb proof above... Oh. Okay, well, this is already climb proof. I know that much. Grade 3. One way glass is... not unlocked, is what it is. Never mind. Right. Well, we need to buff this area up. We need to make this much more popular than it currently is. We need donation boxes. And we need... education stuff. And hopefully that's going to help us out a little bit as well. Six of these in. Our education rating is actually really good, surprisingly enough. Our conservation rating is really good. It's just our guest numbers are about 500 short. Oh, Jesus, lemony Christoph Christ. That's okay, we can work with that. Let's get some education boards up to kick things off. People want to learn about the lions. We really may as well stick these absolutely everywhere. I think that's like the main problem people have with their education rating. They just don't go over the top enough, you know? We need some power, apparently. We can do that. Not a problem. Not a problem. The do-do-do-do. One of the best things about these solar panels... Actually, the best thing about these solar panels, it doesn't annoy the guests. You can put them in, stick it there. And the guests do not give a monkey's uncle. It's beautiful. There we go. Right, you aren't happy about the terrain, are you, I believe? No, 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 no. Again, way too much... it's always the long grass. They hate the long grass. Nobody likes the long grass. Plus, the short grass has got a nicer colour to it, anyway. We need some rock. I really like how this savannah background looks. The rock looks great. Look at that. It's beautiful. There we go. It's pretty cool. Lemmy! Lemmy! People are loving the lions, although it's a bit of a trek. So this is awkward. I didn't even put... Oh, there's a staff path there. Oh, we should swap that. No wonder people aren't coming here. Do, do, do. Perfect. I think you'll all agree. I don't even know how I would make this perfect. I suppose that's better, right? Okay, we're up to 2,400. We're on the way. Guests are very unhappy, which is fine, probably, somehow. All we need to do is get 400 more guests. So, bam. Let's do it. Lions, how are we doing? Are we happier? I know you need enrichment. I'm going to get you some enrichment. But generally speaking, they're doing okay. I still have tons of diseased animals, and it's always these ones in the middle. I don't know what to do. I really don't. Is there a solution? Because it keeps saying it's clean, it's dirty, right? No matter how many times I bring a keeper in, it's still dirty, implying that the problem is the water. And it is, you can tell the water's filthy. But I've got two cleaning things on it. Tell you what, let's give this a go. I'm going to put a cleaning thing there, okay? It's going to sit right next to it, just to prove that I'm not doing anything wrong here. It's going to sit right there, and we'll see if it cleans the water. Because we can always get rid of that later, that's fine. There we go. That's our zoo. Looking very zoo-y. We need to get some guest numbers in. Although we're getting that, we're not far off, despite my many diseased animals. What I'm thinking is we can do a... remember, we had a little bit with the iguana, but it was perfectly set up for more exhibit animals. Exhibit animals are oddly popular, so and they're very easy to handle, so I think it's probably worth doing. So that's a little iguana. Michaela, living on her own, but we could put three more in here. Let's do it. Stop hiccuping. Oh. Wonder if that attaches. Nice! They've set that up really nicely. Look at that. Bam. Bam. Right. What are we going to get? What we want, I guess, is just the highest value we can get. Okay, well, we can get another gold. Gold may have been optimistic. Let's try silver. Okay, silver's good. Let's get some Goliath frogs. Okay, let's try bronze. We can get some. I just want like breeding pairs. Some Titan beetles. And I guess we don't need a breeding pair, so let's get some Western Diamondbacks as well. Right. Good stuff. So you, my friend, live there. Have lots of lovely babies. Why do I have this? I have no idea. Oh, right, yeah. Okay, that makes sense. You go over there. You go over here. And you lovely lasses and lads come over here. Good stuff. Right, let's make them happy. Climate, little bit too high, not much in it. And ambient is, again, the humidity, a little bit too high. Not bad, though. Again, climate just a teeny bit too high, humidity a little bit too low. And over here, we need to bring the humidity down a smidge. That should be good for all of them. Are we good? We are not. Now we are. And next up, we good? We're good. And we are bad on all of them. Sweet. What do you need? Come on, buddy. There we go. Sweet. Okay, there we go. 2,717. Oh, we're getting there. We're 80 away from glory. 80 away from glory. I don't know what to do. Oh, I thought the water had cleared, but it hasn't. Look, it's still dirty. There's a filter right next to it. What do you want from me? I'm gaining. I'm going to just keep having to buy more vets. This is disastrous. Maybe what I need to do is set up like a little vet area. Just have tons of quarantines in one place. I'm going to try that. I have no money. I can't really do that. The guest count is up to 30 away. I'm just going to wait. I'm pretty sure we're about to make it. I'm really surprised this hasn't been fixed yet. Lots of things have been fixed. How has this not been fixed? Am I just meant to deal with it? Is it like a natural dirty spring? This is pretty cool. Maybe that's it. Maybe it's just part of the challenge of the episode. Yay, there we go! Gold, baby, gold! Great Caldera Once Safari again, Park.
You've completely transformed the place. And with those programs in full swing, we're gonna make a real difference to the wild animal population. I know it's my name above the door, so to speak, but this is your legacy now, too. Except in any legal sense, because, believe me, the paperwork is a nightmare. So, before I unleash your talents on your next project, I want to give you one last piece of advice, if I may. Don't just limit your conservation efforts to the zoo. Think of the whole planet. Conserving electricity can be as important as conserving animals. Use public transport. Recycle your rubbish. I try to do something hands-on, like cleaning up the local countryside, at least once a week, and it's kept me young at heart. I just wish it could have kept me young at hairline as well. Right. Well, the Arctic beckons. See you in a few months.
He's a good egg, Bernie, isn't he? And he's right. We need to pay attention to everything. And that includes, you know, it's not just about zoos and stuff. It's about all the little decisions we make to save the planet. And the problem with this is, right, there's this common thing where people, corporations in particular, try to blame us, citizens, for problems with, you know, eco problems, blah, blah, blah. Saying, oh, you know, take the bus and stuff like this, which is something you should do. Everyone should strive to make a little difference. The problem is, it's something like 5 corporations on the planet are responsible for like 70% of greenhouse emissions. We are a tiny, tiny, tiny speck on the spectrum of greenhouse emissions, like as an individual, or even as like humans, as like citizens as general, we're a tiny speck. What you can do, like obviously you should make the changes to look after things, maybe, you know, go help out, clean out your local areas, do the little things to help your communities, but it's important to let people know this isn't acceptable more than anything else. It's important that the people who are capable of making the biggest change actually try to make that change, try to do something about it, otherwise they will never actually improve. Because every single individual on the planet could be the greenest person they could ever be, and we'd still be in trouble. You know? because the people in more positions of power don't have those same incentives. So, those are the people you need to get on about, really. Lion! This is quite a short video so far, so we'll spend 5 minutes hanging around with our animals. Apologies about the cheetah nonsense, it really was not on purpose. For, well, I mean, why would it have been, I guess. I felt kind of lit, I don't know, it's been cool. I'm looking forward to going back and making our own zoo again. I think I preferred that to what we've done here, but it's still perfectly enjoyable. Like the lions, I can't even add any bloody foliage, can I, really? No. Still more wattle bush! Have they hid a wattle bush inside? Yes, there's a cheeky... Alright, I need to get that wattle bush. It's not acceptable. Come here. Oh, no. Wait. And then... I can get it close. It's not perfect. It's not a million miles away. Where's my other... There he is. Yeah, we did it. Gold. Not that bad. Considering this is going on, I think it could have been a lot worse. I'm surprised the education rating... Well, we're up to 4.5. That's really good. Happiness is a little bit low. I suspect they need, like, toilets and stuff like that. And education could be higher, which would have helped. But, yeah. I mean, toilets is actually the one thing they don't need. They need more food and probably benches and stuff like that. But generally speaking, it's been really successful. Let's go meet some of our new animals. Who is new? Got a baby elephant! That's what we need. Baby elephants is always what we need. These having a snooze. There's the baby. I actually love the baby elephants. A damp baby. That's what we all need in our lives at this time, folks. Damp baby. What's that over there? Why is that coloured? I don't know, but I like it. There it is. Caldera National. It's cool, isn't it? It's a good park. I like it. Hope you've all had fun. Don't know what we're doing next. We'll find out in the next video. Yeah, this was easier than I expected. I know that sounds cocky, but I was mainly worried about the education rating. I've always had problems with the education rating, generally speaking. He's so cute! But really, just stick signs absolutely bloody everywhere, and it goes through pretty easily. Are you male or female? What are we looking at here? Hondo. That's a great name for an elephant. There's Hondo, our baby elephant. What else did we get? Oh, we got some baby sables as well. There they are. Who's our new baby sable? That's Adama and Mwanwanwanwa. Pretty sure that's what they're called. A little bit of buffer going on. The sables have been breeding pretty well, actually. I think that's our third baby. Another one over it. Oh, wait, no, that's a... It's a buffer. Yeah, a wildebeest, even. What am I on about? A golden wildebeest at that. It'd be nice if gold animals were born gold. I don't know, I just think that would be entertaining. Oh! I really haven't spent much time with the wildebeest in general. Let's go find one that isn't moist. I would like to see the least moist wildebeest you have, please. There you go, that is not a moist wildebeest at all. What we like to see. They're an odd looking animal, aren't they? It's funny, because the black... Not a care in the world. Yeah, just have a nap instead. Why not? Black wildebeest are definitely the least common in terms of video game representation and other things like that. You know, when people think of wildebeest, I think most people think of the blue wildebeest more than the black wildebeest. Can I ride in this? We should go for a tour. That's what we should do. Although, it's probably not the best time for it, admittedly. How you doing, love? You having fun? Feeling good? You're a weird looking lass, aren't you? Oh, we're on the way. It's a bit of a shame that there's been a traffic jam, but I'm loving the pink tag. What is going on here? You get out of the way. Ruining this. Come here. Jesus, I just want to go on a tour. Alright, we should be good. We should get moving any second now. Any second now. Dana. Mark. Who am I? I am Koblo Flamma. That's right, Koblo Flamma. Just because you've never heard of it doesn't mean it's not our name. What is going on now? I think we're finally on the move. Took about half an hour. Here we go then, let's enjoy this final tour. Choo choo! There's something, Zebra, move, please. Okay, I think we're good. Hello. I love that. That's very cool. There's a feces ejecting elephant. My favourite type of elephant. I think we'll agree. I've got new humans. Hello. You're looking good. How you doing, love? Having a good day? She even looked and nodded. Crazy. Oh, God. What is it now? There's always something going on. Where was that? Where are we backed up? Oh, it's the baby! Get out of the way. We're back! And now we get to see the baby! Where's the baby? There's the baby! Oi, look at the baby, not on me. Just started flirting with you a minute ago, there's no excuse. Focus on the babies! See the wild dogs in there? Choo choo! Oh no. Oh no. It's so hard to do like a full on tour. It's all backed up so much. I just want to sit in a vehicle and watch the freaking tour. That's all I'm trying to do here. It's becoming very difficult. I'm big dumb. I didn't realize you could change it. I just found the option to do it. There we go. I'm on my own. My beloved Dora, where's she gone? Here we go. Oh no. It's the baby. The baby. Hello. Right, mate, how you doing? Oh. 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 Boys? Girls? How we feeling? How we living? We good? We're good. Choo choo! It's not a train, but choo choo! This, I believe, is the cheetah enclosure. But where are the cheetahs? That's the question. Can we spot one? That's the challenge. Can I change seats? This is better. So actually, can I go further back? Nice! This is way better. Still not seeing any cheetahs, though. You do have animals on your animal tour, right? Nope, but we have mechanics. The rare red-hatted mechanic. Only spotted in this very specific part of the park. And also there. He appears to have broken out of his enclosure. Report him to the authorities. Moving on. We're now progressing through to nothing at all whatsoever, but we are going to swing past the lion exhibit. Actually, oh yeah, the giraffe! I didn't realise this was... You see the lions over there, you see the giraffes over there, and a little springbok. Adorable. The game has problems. This mission had problems, but the animals are always cool. Always. And the creative aspect is always cool. It's everything else that needs sprucing up a little. That's really how I feel about Planet Zoo in general, is that the animals are amazing, they look great, the animations are amazing, the sounds are amazing, everything is wonderful. Textures are really good, the models are really good. And then you get this. This is just absolute nonsense going on here. Are you okay? Why are you diseased now? The problem is everyone's diseased because of the water, and now they're diseased for no reason. Everyone just gets diseased constantly. It's always like the game's fighting itself, because the creative building aspects are amazing, the animals are amazing, and then your keepers don't do their job, or something's bugged, and something like that. And it just feels like the game's just beating itself up instead of just, like, harmonious, you know? I still adore the game, I really do, it's like my favourite game in the world right now. I mean, look at that, how can you not adore that giraffe? It's the cutest thing. Little springboks chilling down there. Oh, they're all gonna sit together. Oh, you're perfect. Don't let anyone... Oh, there's a tongue thing I like. Don't let anyone tell you you're not perfect, because you are. You're all... And you're perfect as well. Don't you worry. Would I like to compare the markings? We heard a lot that there's going to be randomized markings on the animals, right? But I think it's more limited than we expected. I believe we just had baby... something. More buffalo... Sables. No, something else. Anyways, there it is, folks. Caldera Safari Park. I quite like the campaign. Like, it's a good opportunity. Obviously, we're doing franchise mode. It's very heavy on the design work and all that kind of stuff. It's nice to play mode where we get to focus on the management and on education scores and all this stuff that I tend to kind of neglect in my franchise mode. We don't build fancy exhibits, it must be said. Although, I think our last park looks pretty good when we get the full control. When it's like this, it's just, simple, isn't it? Simple. Right. So, next video, we are going to move on to whatever the hell's going to happen next. Bernie has gone, so I'm very curious as to what is lying in store for us. We'll have to wait and find out. Until then, thank you very much for joining me. Please do hit the like button if you enjoyed this video and indeed this series. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.